Hello. Let's talk about mixing and storing your paints. Now, with your acrylics, it's kind of like a no-brainer because the acrylics will dry up. That's just the nature of them. So once you're done with your project, and hopefully you'll be able to keep your paints in some type of wet palette, you can use the Stay Wet Handy Palette. You could use, those are all made by Masterson. There's a variety of sizes. But you could also use just some type of like Tupperware container that will allow you to put a few sheets of your paper towel in the bottom of it, dampen that, and then I like to put a sheet of the acrylic disposable paper palettes on top of that and put my palettes on top of that or my paint on top of that. That allows the paint to have the cool moisture from that, but it doesn't absorb quite so quickly because it's got a little bit more repellent there. The other thing you can use are the Wingate Artist palettes. Now, those come in two different size pads. This one that I have here is a 9x12. They also come in, I think it's a 12x14 or 12x16, something like that. We carry both of those for you. I love these because they have a poly coating. They have a flat, you know, it's like a thick cardboard in some respects. But it's got pliability to it. It's got a poly coating shield that allows it to be mixed on and painted. You know, you can really give it a good usage, and then it'll wipe clean so that you could save it for next time. It will stain. Don't worry about the staining. That's not a huge problem. But, or you can just simply toss them. I think there's like 10 sheets in a package of these, so they can be used over and over again. They're really a wonderful resource, but you're not limited to just this type of a surface thing for mixing on. You can use an old chipped dinner plate. You can use a glass cutting board. The important thing is that it have some repellent to it. It's not, you know, you've got, otherwise it's going to absorb the paint. It'll pull the moisture right out of it. So use something that's got a really non-porous surface to it. The other thing you're going to need to do is keep your paints dust-free in between. I don't know about you, but I live in an area, a brand new neighborhood that's still under construction. Dust is rampant. I could dust every single day. Ugh, it's not even funny. But I found these project cases at Office Max. They are under, I think, $8 a set. They have little plastic hinges. They work great. I can slip a 9x12 palette sheet right inside of here. Close it up, walk away from it. It works great also because I have kitties, and one kitty in particular loves to walk right through my paints. So this is a way for me to protect those in the interim. You could actually use something like this as well for your acrylics. Just put your paper towels, dampened paper towels underneath there. I will tell you that this is not as airtight sealed as a Stay Wet palette would be. Or Tupperware of some sort, but it works great for the Genesis, and it would work on a short-term basis for your heavy-bodied acrylics too. So, as long as you keep them with some type of moisture system going in there. Okay, once you've got your paints mixed, you will find that you're going to have leftovers of those. There are storage solutions that you can consider. Let me see if I can find one here. We have little 6-packs of the Genesis 1-ounce jars. These work really great for storage of larger things, but I find that they're really way too big for my little dibble dabs here. So the other thing is our tins. You'll notice they're not very pretty. It doesn't really matter. They're not made to be pretty here. But what they do is they come in, you get 40 of these little tiny 33 millimeter tins with a clear cap. They work great for storing all those little bitty bits of leftover paints. And as you can see, I've got quite a bit going here. And I will dip into these rather than pull into the new, you know, or the big 2 or 1 ounce jars when I've finished a project and I'm getting ready to start a new one. And this is my first resource to see if I've got colors that I can use to start with. So you will find that you can store your leftovers on tin foil. You can, you know, just look to see whatever you've got that won't let the paint get absorbed into it, and keep it dust-free. That's the critical thing. There is the dust-free. So the other thing that I want to show you is this is the drawer to my easel. It comes right out. I love this because it means that my Genesis paints slip in here beautifully. They slide right into my easel, and I can take them with me if I want to go outside and paint, and I don't have to worry about having to take a gazillion little jars of paint and keep them contained. It works so cool for that. So I just had to share that with you. I just think it's the neatest thing that you don't have to fuss if you've got an easel or a traveling easel, because those little 1 ounce jars fit right in there. So, okay, I think that's real good on storage. If you have questions, I keep thinking I'm forgetting something really important here, but if you have questions about that, talk to me, okay? And I'll be able to give you some pointers. See you on the next one. We're going to talk about mixing paints.